गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, आई एम राधिका, योर बायोलॉजी टीचर एट डॉक्टर बिसन स्कूल. होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन एंड डूइंग वेल एट होम. सो वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग टू स्टडी द स्टोरी ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स पार्ट टू. सो टिल नाउ वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट द डिफरेंट यूजेस ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द हार्मफुल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, हाउ दे आर गोइंग टू बी हार्मफुल. इज इट नॉट दैट द इज इट नॉट पॉसिबल Is it possible or not? Though they are useful, they are also harmful, isn't it? If your mother forgets to keep the food in the refrigerator and leaves outside, the next day if you see it starts smelling very foul, isn't it? You are not able to consume that. Your mother says that the food is spoiled. Immediately you throw. So who is spoiling that food? That is no one else but the microorganisms, because the microorganisms are present in the air. Isn't it? They are present in the water. They are present on the skin of the animals. Everywhere they are present. And they are so small we cannot see with our naked eyes. So continuously the food and other substances are exposed to these microorganisms. Now especially during the rainy season you can see, if you have not worn the shoes, if you take out your shoes and see, on that you can see that it has become very black, black patches could be seen. So what are those black or white, if it is the shoes, white, white patches on that. So what are those white colored patches and all? They are nothing but the fungi, okay, which has grown, and it is a microorganism. Similarly on the spoiled food also, on the bread and all that. And 7th class also we have seen the bread or the coconut and all, on that we can see that the fungus grows, isn't it? Similarly, sometimes the fruit or the vegetable has become very soft. Okay, though that black color substance is not seen, that means inside that some microorganism is growing. Because of that, it has spoiled the food. Okay, that fruit or the vegetable, and the smell would be completely different from the normal. Similarly, every time we are also affected by many diseases. Already from the beginning, I am talking about these diseases, isn't it? So these microorganisms are causing many diseases in us. Okay, in us human beings, in the animals, in the plants, in the livestock, that is all the domestic animals, and also in the plants. Okay, so they are causing different types of diseases. As they have to survive, they cause all these diseases. Okay, so what are those diseases and how we can prevent them? What is the method? All that we are going to study under harmful microorganisms. Okay, so here, if you go to the doctor, normally we have observed the different types of medicines and other things are given by the doctor for the disease. Okay, children, just a minute, I'll get the chalk piece. Okay, so I've got the chalk piece, and now we shall be seeing about all these microorganisms. Okay, so how they will enter, how they are able to enter into our body. So with the help of our food, our hands, okay, our while breathing through the air they will enter, the water we drink, the food we eat, our clothes, okay. Clothes means if an infected person is there, some with some disease, we go to him, okay, and from there the those pathogens may come to our body. Okay, like there are different ways are there. Why we are talking about all this? Because now it is the time for this corona pandemic. Everyone is asking you to wash your hands. Why you have to wash the hands? First I'll go and explain about that, then we'll go about other diseases. Okay, we know that this COVID is spreading by air or through the, what is that, saliva, isn't it? Or through the sneeze, or when a person coughs through the air, then that means what, it is actually infecting our lungs, okay, the respiratory system. So if at all a person is having that in the body, okay, in his body, so what happens naturally when he sneezes or when he coughs, okay, that through that sneeze or the cough that travels and falls in the opposite person, okay, anyone who is there surrounding him, okay. So like that, if that person may get infected, that is the reason we have to put the mask, so that if at all anyone is having, you are exposed to a person who is having COVID, that does not come to you because you are having a mask, okay. But what happens, see, you are exposed to that virus has come to your mask, and after that you keep removing the mask, you touch with your hands and remove the mask, okay. So there are high chances that that virus comes into your to your face. You should, once you have touched certain things, you just see what happens when that person sneezes or coughs. Those droplets will fall on the surroundings. Okay, so if you touch certain things, on those things that virus is there. And with the same hands you are removing the cuff, you are wiping your face and all that, immediately what happens, that virus has got high chance to remain here. So after that, again you have removed the mask happily. With that hand which has been exposed to so many things, it is having the virus. With that hand you have wiped nicely your face. Okay, and again you have put the mask. So there is no use of that mask. There is absolutely no use of that mask, because already the virus was there on your hand, and whatever protection was there, that you removed and sent the virus there directly to the nose or the mouth, and you have covered with the mask again. So that virus, now it cannot go back also. It will remain there happily and enter into your body. Okay. So that means what we have to do, why I am telling about all these, the proper precautions, what precautions we have to take to prevent such things. Okay, so this is about that coronavirus. Okay, so now apart from this, the other diseases like cold is also spread like that. But if you are getting typhoid, that is spread through water or the food. Okay, or if you are getting by clothes, okay, air and clothes, chicken pox, all these things. So there are, and some diseases are there which are transmitted by the animals. Okay, by the animals. See, generally you say that malaria. What is causing malaria? Which organism is causing malaria? It is. Is it mosquito? Many of you would have said mosquito. No, no, it is not mosquito. It is a protozoan, that is Plasmodium. Okay, but why I am telling mosquitoes will be carrying that? Because this Plasmodium will enter into the mosquito. And when the mosquito bites us, it will inject those microorganisms, that is the protozoa, that is Plasmodium, into our body. Once it enters, this will grow further, and again from one person to another person, it can go by the mosquitoes only. Okay. So like this, or sometimes the food is there, exposed food is there nowadays. So on that, the house flies set. They have gone to so many places, all the dirty places, okay, into the drain they would have gone, on the roadside they would have sat, or they would have been sitting on the dustbin. From there they come and sit on the food that is exposed without any lid. So what happens, whatever microorganisms they are there to their legs, they have carried all those and deposited happily on our food, and unknowingly we consume the food. Okay, thinking that it's so tasty. Afterwards, we get the diseases. After we get the disease, we realize, okay, somewhere I have not eaten the food properly. Okay, uncovered food or the contaminated food I have eaten from somewhere. Then we discover all this. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to always keep the food covered. All those precautions we are going to see. For now, first we shall write about the disease, some definitions that are there, then we'll go to the next part. Okay. So diseases, we can study about the diseases caused in human beings. So today our topic is diseases caused in human beings. Okay, children, so for that we have to write the some definitions like pathogens. What are pathogens? What are pathogens? Microorganisms which cause diseases are called pathogens. Microorganisms which cause diseases are called pathogens. Okay, example. What examples we can give? Bacteria, virus, etc. Okay, and we see that these diseases are transmitted from one person to another person. That's why we call them as communicable diseases. Okay. So, communicable diseases. When diseases are transmitted from one person to another person then such diseases are communicable diseases. They are called as communicable diseases. Okay. Then mode of these are transmitted. How they can be transmitted from one person to another? Just now I told. Transmitted by air or water or food. Okay, clothes, touch, or that is physical contact. Contact or vectors. Vectors means animals. I told about this one. What is that? Mosquito, isn't it? So that is a vector. But if you say house fly, okay, they are like vectors, like mosquito. Okay, vectors like animals. Vectors are the animals. Example is malaria by mosquito. That means it is carried by mosquito, caused by plasmodium. Okay, so here we have seen. So the diseases that are affected by, say you say that what common cold is there. Okay, it is by air. It is typhoid by water or food. Jaundice also we get by food. Okay, chickenpox by air, by touch. Okay, then vectors like malaria. Okay, so in case of this malaria and all, we have to prevent the growth of the remaining of stagnant water. About this, I would like to tell an important thing. I have told that the plasmodium is causing malaria. Okay, so first you note down, then I'll discuss about all that. First complete noting down all this. You noted on all this? Okay. See, I'll just rub it off, then I'll discuss about this malaria and other diseases also. First, I'll make the table. In the table, I'll be explaining. It is easy for you all to write and understand also. Okay. So, we shall start with the table. I'll make a table so that you can write accordingly and remember. Okay, for each I will give two examples. Virus 2, बैक्टीरिया, ओके, देन फॉर एवरीथिंग आई विल गिव टू टू एग्जाम्पल. सो फर्स्ट वन इज नेम ऑफ द डिसीज. फर्स्ट कॉलम विल बी नेम ऑफ द डिसीज. ओके, सेकेंड वन causative microorganism, or here I write pathogen. Okay, so that you will remember that word, pathogen. Okay, so this one I'll make small. That's it. Next one is mode of transmission. Mode of transmission. How it is transmitted from one person to another. Okay, next is preventive measures. How we can prevent that? Preventive measures. So first one we shall write. Okay children, so first one we shall write about tuberculosis. This tuberculosis, you have to remember all these. Okay, so what is the pathogen? What is causing that? It is the bacteria. It is caused by a bacteria. Okay, anything else we can write like that? Under this only I'll write the rest also. Okay, here mode of transmission is air. The mode of transmission is air. Fatally infect the lungs. Then it can be prevented by the vaccination. What is that vaccination? That is BCG. Okay, next one is avoid infected persons, towels, handkerchiefs. Avoid infected persons, towels, handkerchiefs, etc. Okay, next one we shall write further about bacteria only. I'll write cholera and typhoid. Okay, cholera, typhoid. See, that one spreads through the, this one spreads through the air. So this is also caused by bacteria, but it is spread by contaminated food and water. Okay, by contaminated water, food, housefly. Contaminated water, food, housefly. Housefly means it will be carrying the pathogens, isn't it? That's why I told like that. Then how we can do? By simply we have to increase the personal hygiene. Personal hygiene. Hygiene means cleanliness. Okay, personal hygiene. And good sanitary conditions. And good sanitary conditions. That is regularly washing our hands and all. Okay, that is good sanitary conditions. Next one, what else we have to do? We have to drink boiled water. When we boil the water, all the microorganisms are killed. Drink boiled water. Okay, so that finishes about bacteria. Next one we shall go to, here I just close it off. Okay, Next we shall go to chicken pox. Two examples I will write. Chicken pox. Next one, polio. Okay, chicken pox by virus, polio also virus. Okay, it is transmitted by air, polio by air and water also. It will transmit even with water. Okay, so for this, how we can do? We can take a vaccination. Varicella. Varicella, sorry, it is S. Vaccine. Okay, and for polio, you all are aware, isn't it? Polio drops. That is also vaccine only. Next one, we shall go to. Completed this one. Okay, next one we shall go to malaria. Here I will give malaria. Okay, I'll take one more, that is dengue. Malaria is caused by plasmodium, that is a protozoa. Okay, it is a protozoa. Okay, name of that is plasmodium, and dengue is caused by a virus. Here it is plasmodium, I'll write in bracket, that is the name of that pathogen. Okay, then it is transmitted by mosquitoes. Okay, this is also a vector. Just now we have seen the house fly, no, like that. Okay, then this one also, dengue also by mosquitoes. Okay, how we have to do? By using the mosquito nets. Okay, and we have to use mosquito nets. Okay, prevent growth of mosquitoes. In the rainy season, in the TV also they will give advertisement, don't keep the tires open or the stagnant water like that, isn't it? Why? For that. So first you write down this, then I will explain about that. Okay, children. Okay, so here you have, please note down this, you have noted down. Then we shall see, first one is tuberculosis, I told that it is caused by bacteria and the pathogen is air, the pathogen is bacteria, it is transmitted by air. Okay, and it can be prevented by the vaccination, that is BCG vaccine. Okay, and also we should avoid, if at all someone has got, we have to keep that person separately, we should not regularly talk, because through the air it gets transmitted, isn't it? We should avoid all his clothes, his belongings, everything, and separate him. Then the others will not get. The next one is digestive system. So they both of them are caused by bacteria only, and both of them are transmitted by the contaminated water, food, and all. Now it is rainy season, so one of the most common diseases all children get, that is cholera and typhoid, because of consumption of this contaminated water. Anyway, now outside food is also not much available, so less chances that you all get this. Then how we can do prevent that? By personal hygiene and good sanitary conditions, regularly keeping ourselves clean. Okay, and our surroundings very neat and clean, then we don't get. And if at all the water we have a doubt, we should always boil and have. Next one is chicken pox and polio. Both are caused by the virus, and then it is transmitted by air. This one, polio by air and water. For this also we have the vaccine, that is varicella vaccine and the polio drops. Okay, now the last one, that is, see here the mode of transmission is air, water, food, and then housefly. Here we have seen, now here we are seeing malaria. Okay, which is a common disease affecting us all. So it is caused by a protozoan. The name of that is plasmodium. Okay, and it is transmitted from one person to another person by mosquitoes. So it is not caused by mosquitoes. It is only carried by mosquitoes. Okay, so for that we have to prevent the growth of these mosquitoes. We should not leave the water open. Why? Because the mosquitoes will lay eggs in that stagnant water and the larvae will grow into new mosquitoes. So we should not keep such things. Similarly, the dengue is caused by a virus, but it is also transmitted by the mosquitoes. So even for that also we should take preventions. Okay, so when I am talking about all this, are about the the plasmodium. Okay, and it is carried by the mosquito. This was discovered by a scientist. His name is Dr. Ronald Ross. Okay, so he was a scientist who lived in India. Okay, so before the independence. And he found that in certain places, wherever the open places, open containers or the stagnant water is more, in such places the mosquitoes are growing more. And in those places he found that the people are suffering more with malaria. When he carefully traced out and found that the mosquito, that is female Anopheles mosquito. Okay, the malaria is carried by not all mosquitoes, but female Anopheles. It is carried by female Anopheles mosquito. I just rub this off. Okay, all have noted now. So I just rub it off and write. Okay, so he found that it is carried by the female Anopheles mosquito. Okay, he observed that wherever it is growing more, there he could find. I'll write now, read this out. Do you know box in that it is given? Dr. Ronald Ross discovered that female Anopheles mosquitoes are the carriers of the causative microorganism or the parasite for malaria. For this discovery, Dr. Ronald Ross got Nobel Prize in 1902. He discovered it in Secunderabad. For full story, you can see the annexure. Okay, discovery of Ross, you can see the annexure. So when you get the textbooks, you all can read the annexure after the lesson. These are very, very interesting parts given after every lesson. Okay, so who discovered about this Anopheles mosquito? Okay, Dr. Ronald Ross. His name is Dr. Ronald Ross. He discovered that female Anopheles is the scientific name. Okay, female Anopheles mosquito carries pathogen. Okay, for malaria. And what is that pathogen? That is nothing but the name of that is Plasmodium. Okay. Okay, children, so you must remember this. And he got the Nobel Prize in 1902. Okay, so we have seen the work of Dr. Ronald Ross. So that finishes the harmful microorganisms that are causing diseases in human beings. So in the next videos, we shall be seeing how the microorganisms can cause diseases in the animals and also in the plants. Okay, children, thank you for now. Complete all these works and send the images to me. Okay.